Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 4.3 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is, a member is made from a material that has specific weight gamma and modulus of elasticity E. If it is in the form of cone having the dimension shown, determine how far its end is displaced due to gravity when it is suspended in vertical position. So you can see this is the cone having dimension, the length is L and the radius is given as R naught. This is y-axis and this is x-axis. So you have to determine when it is suspended vertical, how far this ends move when it is suspended vertically. So let's start with the solution. Now you can see the internal force varies, since you can see if you move from this position, the weight is going to increase. So weight is a function of length L, or weight is a function of y. If we move in y direction, the weight is different, clear? So what we will do is that we will cut this cone at any distance of y from this base x, and we will see, we will find a relationship between its radius and length, and then from that we will find the weight of this this section, which is wy, which is a function of y. So what if I cut it at this point, and that is at a distance of y from this base, and if I draw the free body diagram, so it will be like this. Okay, now this is your x-axis, clear? And from this vertical apex, this is your y-axis. Let this radius is taken as x, clear? And this x varies at different value of y. Here this will be different, and at various length of y this x varies. So, and this is at a distance of y from this base axis, clear? This is a distance of y. So what we will do is that, if you can see that this is a right angle triangle, and from this cone again we can see this is also a right angle triangle. So if I take R naught by L, that will be equal to same as x by L. So let me write it, x over y will be equal to R naught over L. So from this we will get x is equal to R naught over L multiplied by y. So this is the relationship of the radius of this cone with respect to y. So what if you know the length at this, so you can find the radius at this point. Similarly, if you know the length at this and you want to find the radius, so you can find this by just plugging the value of y. Now what will be the volume of cone? So the volume of cone having base of radius x and height y. So for this cone, for base x and height y, so the volume of cone is written as, I will write it, volume of cone having base of radius x and height y is equal to v, and that is equal to 1 over 3 pi y multiplied by x cube. This is the formula, clear? So we know that x is this one, so just plug it in this formula. So 1 over 3 pi y multiplied by x is R naught over L into y, and that is cube. So when you solve this, you will get y, this is square, sorry, this is square. So this will be also square. So when you solve this, you will get volume of this cone having base radius of x and height y will comes out to be pi R naught square into y cube divided by 3L square. So this will be the volume of this cone. Now what about the weight of this cone? So you can see that this weight will act at this point. So this will be weight, and this weight will be function of y, Clear? So when this weight acts downward, so there will be internal reaction force which will be acting upward, and that will be P of Y. So from equilibrium condition, we know that P of Y will be equal to W of Y. Since W is a function of Y, as we move away from base axis, the weight increases. So we will find this weight P of Y, or weight, so P of Y is equal to weight, and weight of the cone can be represented as specific weight, let me check it, specific weight gamma into volume of this cone. So if I multiply this gamma with volume, so volume is pi r naught square over 3L square multiplied by Y cube. So this will be this reaction force in this cone. Clear? Now we know that what is the elongation in this cone when it is suspended. So that will be equal to P of Y into its length, which is dy. Let's take dy because it is variable. If you want to find a differential element dy, so let this is dy. So for this dy, an area will be equal to ay, because area is also a function of x or y, because as we move along y, so area will also change into e. So just plug in the value, P is equal to gamma, clear, into gamma into pi r naught square y cube over 3L square multiplied by dy divided by what will be the area. So area is equal to pi x square, because x is the radius. So plug in the value, pi x is this one, r naught divided by L multiplied by y. Clear? Okay, so this will give you area. So if square, so from here I will get pi r naught square over L square multiplied by y square. Okay, so plug in the value, pi r naught square multiply by y square divide by L square. There, and E is there. And you can see this is for small differential element dy. So what if integrate from 0 dy, y start from 0 to L. So I will again integrate here from 0 to L. Okay. Now this displacement, you can see this R cube, this is gamma, this is not R. So this R square will cut with this, this pi will cut with this, this y square. Let me check where I have made a mistake. Okay, this y square is there, it will cut with this, so we will left with y. Okay, so here we have y, and this L square will cut with this. So you will left with integral from 0 to L gamma into y divided by 3e. Okay. And here we have dy as well. So when you solve this, take gamma over 3e because these are constant. So you have 0 to L y into dy. Okay. So from here we have gamma over 3e, and integral of y is y square divided by 2, and limit will be from 0 to L. So just plug in the value. So it will be equal to L square over 2 minus 0 square over 2. So when you solve this or simplify it further, you will get gamma L square over 6e. So this is the vertical displacement of end of this cone when it is subjected to, when it is suspended from the fixed end. And that was all about this example 4.3. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it, and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.